हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ई कीड़ा। टाइटल ऑफ द लेक्चर इज स्पैन एंड सैग इन ट्रांसमिशन लाइन। फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज स्पैन? स्पैन स्पैन इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू लाइन सपोर्ट। द सपोर्ट मे बी पोल और टावर। इट इज अ डिस्टेंस। दिस इज द पॉइंट ऑफ सपोर्ट। So the gap between the two poles is known as span. Gap between two poles or towers is known as span. Now sag. These are poles or towers. It is a point of support. Sag. What is sag? Sag, conductor wound in this way. So the difference between the lowest point and point of support means reference point is called sag. This is sag. This is the lowest point and this is the point of support, means the reference point. Sag is given by S is equals to WL square upon 8T, where L is the length of the span. Length of span. S is sag. T is conductor tension and W is conductor weight. So from this, sag depends on weight of conductor, span length, tension and temperature. Fourth is temperature. Temperature increases, conductor expands, then sag also increases. These are the factors on which sag depends. When sag is equals to span, there are two poles or towers. Point of support. Sag is equals to span. This is conductor. Means when conductor are tightly strung. There are some advantages and disadvantages. Advantages, it require less conductor. Then cost of conductor less. Ground clearance good. But there are some disadvantages. Tension increases. Supporting pole can break or tend. Insulator can break, which causes accident. So from S is equals to WL square upon 8T, it is seen that S is directly proportional to W. When sag increases, weight is also increases. Sag also directly proportional to length, and sag is inversely proportional to tension. So these are the advantages and disadvantages when sag is equals to span, means when conductor are tightly strung. When loose string, there are some advantages and disadvantages. Advantages, less tension, less chance to break conductor. And disadvantages, obviously when loose string, ground clearance decreases, cost increases, and conductor material also increases. So sag value will be more or less. There are conditions for sag. Two cases, winter and summer. In winter, conductor are tightly wound, and in summer, so there are two cases, winter and summer. In winter, conductor shrink in which chance of breaking is more because of tension increases. Next case is summer. In summer, conductors expand. Means sag value increases and comes near the ground, which increases the accident probability. In summer, sag increases, conductor uses more, and cost of the conductor also increases. Now, methods for calculating sag. There are two methods for calculating sag. First is parabolic method, and second one is catenary method. In parabolic method, span length is less than 300 meter, and sag value less than 5%. In catenary method, span length is greater than 300 meter and sag value greater than 5%. Difference between methods. In parabolic method, some error in parabolic method arise. Higher the length means two tower distance high, then error value also high. And in catenary method, it did more analysis, it gives more accurate result. Now, factors affecting sag. There are some factors which affect sag. First is weight of conductor. Because sag value is directly proportional to weight. Second, working tensile strength. Sag is inversely proportional to working tensile strength. Third, span length. Sag is directly proportional to span length. And the last one is temperature. If temperature is low, then sag low. If temperature is high, then sag will be high. Because when temperature low, sag contracts means shrink, and when temperature is high, sag expand. Sag value increases. See, analysis of sag and tension is an important consideration in overhead transmission as well as distribution line design. And continuity and quality of electrical service largely depend on whether the conductors have properly installed or not. Thus, a design engineer must determine in advance the amount of sag and tension to be given to the conductor at a given temperature, means at maximum wind, possible ice load. I already told you that in summer, sag expands and shrink in winter. So we'll see sag and tension for different types of conductor, like for tower in plain areas, tower crossing the river, or not at the same altitude, means for hilly areas. Main factors in designing and shrinking of conductor on support. First main factor is the conductor load per unit length, means conductor itself, distance between the tower 100 meter 200 meter depends what type of voltage used. Second main factor is conductor tension. Third main factor is span, means distance between support. And last one is temperature. Now, for determining the conductor load, the factors that need to be considered are the weight of conductor itself. Second, weight of ice, snow aligning to a conductor in hilly areas, ice in snow form. And last factor, wind blowing against conductor. You have to remember these main factors that need to be considered for determining the conductor load. First, weight of conductor itself. Second, weight of ice aligning to conductor. And third one is the wind blowing against conductor. Maximum effective weight of the conductor is the vector sum of the vertical weight of the conductor and the horizontal wind pressure. Extremely important to include the most adverse condition. There are two cases. Case 1, when supports are at equal level, and case 2, when supports are at unequal level. Example, hilly area. first calculation for case 1 when supports are at equal level. For analysis, take small portion of conductor, analyze it, end of the result, generalize it. Take a point on conductor at x distance. Suppose this is x distance, this is x, coordinate xy, this is a vertical distance y, weight of conductor wx, weight of conductor wx, horizontal tension t, right relation, ty is equals to wx into x by 2. X by 2, this is the x by 2 distance. So y is equals to wx square upon 2t. If y is s and x is l by 2, then we can write this s is equals to wl square upon 8t. Sag formula. L is the span length, W is the weight of conductor per unit length, and T is the horizontal tension. Now, case second. Now, calculation of sag when supports are at unequal level. These supports are at unequal level, level 1, level 2. Difference is sag in the middle of conductor, but here in middle it doesn't exist. We know x1 plus x2 is equals to L. Total length, first equation. This is, what is sag? You know what is sag? Sag is the difference between the lowest point and the point of support. This is the point of support. A, point of support B. So, point of support A and the lowest point, this is sag 1. Point of support B and the lowest point sag 2 is S2. And this is A and B height. Now, x1 plus x2 equals to L, we know. So, s1 is equals to wx1 square upon 2t. For A, sag value is wx1 square upon 2t. And for sag B, s2 is equals to wx2 square upon 2t. So, S2 minus S1 is equals to Wx square upon 2t minus Wx1 square upon 2t. We know S2 minus S1 is equals to H. See here in the diagram. S2 minus S1 is equals to h. Put the value s2 minus s1 is equals to h, then write this h equals to w upon 2t. We can write this x2 minus x1 plus x2 plus x1, and we know x2 plus x1 is l. So write h equals to wl upon 2t x2 minus x1. So, x2 minus x1 is equals to 2th upon wl. This is equation number 2. So, from equation 1 and 2, equation number 1 is x1 plus x2 is equals to l. And second equation is x2 minus x1 equals to 2th upon wl. We can calculate the value of x1 and x2. x1 is equals to l by 2 minus th upon wl, where is x2 is equals to l by 2 plus th upon wl. For calculation part of you must know two more formula, that is working tension is equals to working stress into area. And working stress is equals to ultimate strength upon safety factor. This is important from numerical point of view. Now, effect of ice loading and wind loading. These formulas for sag are for normal condition, means still air and at normal temperature. But in India, there is a lot of diversity. Example, hilly area. In winters, there is a snowfall. And conductor may have ice coating and simultaneously subject to the wind pressure. Ice loading and simultaneously subjected to wind pressure. Suppose ice loading, this is ice coating on conductor. And horizontally wind pressure. Ice coating, suppose the distance is d of the conductor, then this is the thickness of ice coating t vertically downward. I already told you maximum effective weight of the conductor is a vector sum of vertical weight of conductor and horizontal wind pressure. This is the horizontal wind pressure. This is the vertical weight of conductor. Weight of conductor plus weight of ice. Resultant sum. Total weight. Resultant weight. Resultant weight. Where WW is the pressure.
Thank you.